Last time, I tried to make a hot wire cutter, and it never reached the temperature I wanted. Now, I think I know why. First, the screw eyes I used were really chunky, and offered a lot of contact surface for heat to transfer away from the wire. This time, I'm going for something a lot smaller. Second, I messed up the evaluation of my nichrome wire gauge. I do not have a commonly used round nichrome wire, but a nichrome ribbon. While I initially estimated my wire gauge based on its equivalent surface section for a round wire, I see now this was not a smart move. For a same surface section, a ribbon has a thinner core, and more outside contact surface than a round wire, meaning they will behave differently transferring energy to the air around them. Third, while I thought it would be a quick and easy job, I only attached my nichrome wire loosely to the screw eyes. As the wire warmed up and expanded, I may not have had optimal contact and electrical flow during my first attempt. This time, I'm making sure now everything is super tight. Last. The infrared thermometer was not the right instrument to use to measure the wire temperature. It all comes down to that statement found in the user manual.
The object to be measured for accurate measurements must be at least double the size of the measurement field.
For this second attempt, I will therefore not worry about the temperature, but let the material speak for itself. If the wire cuts what I want to cut, we is for me at the right temperature. Let's go. I have now achieved the maximum temperature that my power adapter can drive without dying. So let's test if this is good enough.